Hey, what's going on YouTube? Welcome back to City Brick Studios here, guys. Today's week three of the LEGO Star Wars The Clone Wars mock. If you want to call it a base, go for it. I consider this a base. But anyways, guys, today I have a very, very long update video. I've made a lot of really good progress. A lot of smaller stuff, minus the exterior base over there. I'll get to that part. Probably starting first, actually, just to kind of get that out of the way. But anyways, guys, let's hop right into this without wasting any time. So guys, if you guys have spent the time watching week two, you have noticed that this whole area was kind of done already, and I just wanted to add some more trees. I wanted to add a lot of plant life. I wanted to add some details. None of the figures minus that one are actually down yet, but I do finally have the tank in there. I do have the rock work kind of all figured out. I do have the bridge, like I said, I would have built by this week. That was definitely a big focus for me. It's not very complex at all. I kind of want it to be simple. Don't worry, it's going to be filled with battle scenes. It's probably going to have a couple speeders, you know, a couple of the other speeders here. I have details on the base I got to show you guys in a second. Also, just to let you guys know, I have a lot more minifigures going into this mock. I do actually want to use some Wolfpack troopers that I need to probably borrow from a friend. So I will kind of have to have that ready for the mock also, guys. The gunship's over there. And possibly I'll be able to fit maybe another Separatist tank. I don't know. The battlefield over here is not that big. I mean, it's not small by any means, but it's not really that big. I don't have it, like, too overcrowded with vehicles because I tend to not like mocks like that. But just going over some of the stuff that I worked here, guys, kind of made, like, a little creek in there going into the river that this tank is kind of crushing. This tank is going over this little creek and these kind of trees right here. There's some collapsed right there. I did build a couple more trees, just four in total. I also kind of shored up some of the plant life over here. And I did finish like the waterfall area. I do want to add a bunch of water studs actually onto this whole water area here. Kind of make it look realistic. Also, I do want to have some stuff splashing in it, like a 501st or a droid body here or there. Really, really cool. Also, I do want to put a Corporate Alliance tank in there. I don't know if you guys know what that is, but that's kind of like the droid tank with like a wheel in the center of it. Also, I told you guys I would show you guys the exterior base from this point of view. I did finish that up. I do have a lot of details on it. These yellow things are kind of representative of like lights and whatnot, so I'm kind of blocking the light right now. But then these kind of red highlight details, these darker red pieces to signify Republic colors, are really, really cool. I do like how I did that on the mock. Obviously, if you guys also don't know, from the interior perspective, this door is fully movable on both sides. You can slide it on that side back and forth, or you can go on this side and just easily slide that there. That's what it looks like with the door open from kind of a minifigure level perspective, which is really, really cool. I do like how that looks. I wanted to keep it simple. I wanted to keep it, you know, minifigure accessible so I can easily move stuff in and out of it. But anyways, guys, now that we're done with the exterior of that, which will be completely beefed up next week four for the update for that, let's go to the inside of the base, guys. Made a lot of progress. One cool scene, I don't know if I showed it in week two, I can't remember, but I did build kind of like a crash Separatist shuttle over here. Really, really cool. I do have some fire details kind of going around it. I think it looks pretty cool. I do want to have like a smaller battle here with some jetpack troopers, which are all in this bin minus this one right there. But yeah, these speeders, I don't know if I'm going to have them in action. I'm not really sure. Also, another thing, guys, if I do have the gunship during this mock in it, I'm going to have to probably put it in this area because I built kind of a cool interior area over there. Not 100% done yet, but since we're going to the interior area, I'll kind of move over to that direction. I did kind of build a barrack, or if you want to say like bunks for these clones, I did build four of them. So you can fit eight troopers in there, which is cool. There's also a little doorway here to get into there. And then right on the kind of side of it, because I kind of wanted to have it in the same general area, I kind of have a small medical bay. I haven't built any medical like equipment yet. I do have this one like stretcher bed out here with a trooper there. But I do want to have that kind of filled up with some stuff, with some medical droids and whatnot. Also, another interior space that I've really worked on is the quote-unquote like armory or barrack, if you want to call it. Then I also built, I wouldn't say like a cafeteria, I'd say like a meeting room, conference room area. I'll start with the barrack though, guys. I'm sure you guys have probably seen this helmet rack design before. I do really like it. I did come up with it myself. I use it in basically everything. I use it in stop motions. It's just, I don't really see a purpose to remake something that I think is already good. So I just continue to use them because I think they look good. But anyways, guys, the Barrack, I do have a couple of 501st helmets on there. One old school one. I do want to have some old school 501st in the mock as well. But I also built this kind of gun rack here. It looks actually really, really good. The studs will be covered. Some of them will be covered, I should say, with some guns. Obviously, this one rack is over here that you can see. It completely covered by guns and whatnot. And then over here, guys, I do have two kind of conference tables. I do like those pieces. I like to use that. I know they have some studs on it, but it's easier to place stuff on it without having to tile off everything, because I kind of ran out of tile with this long pathway that kind of goes down here. Also, guys, I did build a couple control panels. That one's, I have to find a different piece for it, but I also need to put this giant piece there. But once it's all said and done with all the Jedi near it, or if the Jedi are going to be out there, I don't know how I'm going to position it for the finale. I do want to have that kind of shirt away and whatnot. Also, guys, another cool little minifigure level area that you guys can probably see is the 501st AT-RT rack. Here is Sergeant Apo kind of giving some 501st troopers some commands, probably getting ready to go out to battle, you know, getting them all ready and whatnot. And then obviously having these six walkers here is just, it's incredible. It really is. I don't know how else to say it. You know, having them all lined up, they do really look really, really good. That custom design, a lot more minifigure scale. Obviously, there's an ARF trooper right next to it with a ladder. He's about to climb up his. I don't know how many I'm going to have active during the battle and how many I'm going to have not active, because I do want to place like one or two out there near the bridge. And I also have all these other speeders that I have to use in there, and all those other minifigures still that I have not put on the mock. So definitely going to have to figure out how I want to lay all this out for the finale video, which is coming faster than I thought it would. Making a lot of good progress. I would say this week was a bit of a touch-up week, getting some big stuff done, like the bridge, like I said I wanted to do, getting some of the plant life done, and, you know, getting the tank positioned how I wanted, the crushed trees that I wanted. So it's all come together, guys. It really is. Can't thank you guys enough for your support so far here on the channel. I'll kind of end with this little cool shot here, just to do it. Why not, you know? So anyways, YouTube, I hope you guys enjoyed this mock update video. This is just week three of this mock. If you guys want to check out the other videos, make sure you guys go check that out. And anyways, guys, I will see you guys on the next one.